Good afternoon, friends, and welcome to the Munich, Germany, here at the 1972 Olympic Games shooting range for the second final of the day, 10-meter air rifle women. I'm Hillary Russell, and it's my pleasure to have USA's rifle shooter, Kelsey Emmy, here with me today. Welcome, Kelsey, and thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
So you're kind of a new face. I haven't seen you around. This is your first World Cup?
Yes, I just started traveling recently.
Yeah, and how are you liking it?
I like it a lot, actually. It's a good experience, and it's fun, and that's exciting.
That's great. Now tell me, how long have you been shooting for?
Oh, I've been shooting for a long time, but I competitively probably about the last 7 years.
Okay. And what inspired you to start?
Oh, mostly my dad.
Yeah?
I've been shooting with him since I was really little and just kept shooting, and then we just progressed from there.
And is he an air rifle shooter?
He actually recently started shooting small bore, but
okay.
No air rifle yet.
Okay. So it's really nice to have you here. What do you think about the finals hall here?
It's really nice. Like, everything here in Munich is a really nice complex, and I like it a lot.
But it's really cold.
Yes.
Unseasonably cold here in Munich. We've been shivering away in the finals hall and not wanting to go outside basically at all. So we're going to have a chance to introduce our finalists in just about a minute or so. So tell me a little bit about what your typical day of training consists of, Kelsey.
Right now I'm in college, and so normally it's just we practice early in the morning, well, during school.
Yeah.
We practice early and practice for about 2.5 to 3 hours and just work mentally and physically on stamina and just getting everything fine-tuned.
Okay. And so you said you're going to college. Where are you going?
Yep, I go to Murray State University in Kentucky.
And what are you studying?
Criminal justice.
No kidding. Good for you. So it's hard to like combine training and also studying something that important?
It just took a little bit to get used to it, but now it's easier to separate it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I would think that, to find time for friends if you're studying and, you know, training and everything, it must be kind of hard.
It gets a little tricky at times, yeah. But when we practice early, it kind of gives you the afternoon off. So.
And what's your plan after this World Cup?
I hope to go back, and then we'll have our USA Nationals, and we'll shoot that at Fort Benning, Georgia, where they just held the World Cup.
The World Cup, yeah, exactly.
Yep, and so then I'll train from there.
Great, great, that's wonderful.
Stop. Unload. Please lay down your rifles and turn to the face spectators.
And here they are, our 8 finalists today. Not a big surprise, we have 2 women from the People's Republic of China entering into the final, and it's going to be interesting because, as you all know by now, all the qualification scores are eliminated. Everyone starts off with 0, and so it's anybody's game.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the organizing committee of the ISSF World Cup Munich 2013 and the International Shooting Sport Federation welcome you to the Olympic Shooting Range Munich. The finals competition for the 10-meter air rifle women's event will now begin. It's my pleasure to
So on firing point H, representing Austria, we have Lisa UNGERANK. She was a bronze medalist in London in 2012.
In London, please welcome Lisa UNGERANK.
On firing point G, representing France, we have Emilie EVESQUE. She has never entered into a final round of a World Cup in this discipline before. On firing point F, representing Germany, we have Jessica Mager. And so I'm sure that the German spectators are happy to see one of their women in the final today. On firing point E, representing the Czech Republic, we have Nikola Mazurova. She has never entered into a final round of a World Cup before either. Then on firing point D, representing the Islamic Republic of Iran, we have Nangares Imamgouli. She also has never entered into a final round of a World Cup before, although she was a gold medalist in 2011 during the Asian Championships. On firing point C, representing Serbia, we have Andreja Arsovic. She has started off the season absolutely in style. She's won two gold medals during the 3P, Fort Benny and Shang Wang, and so we're going to see what she can get done today, maybe end up on the podium. On firing point B, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Yi Siling, everyone's favorite sweet girl, gold medalist during the Olympic Games in 2012.
Current world number one, Yi Siling.
And on firing point A, also representing the People's Republic of China, we have Chang Jing. And she won the silver medal just recently in Fort Benning, a face that we haven't seen before Fort Benning, and she's really doing a great job. So would you mind telling us a little bit, Kelsey, about the new finals format, what we should expect to see today?
After the preparation period, they start off in two three-shot groups, and they each get 150 seconds for each three shots. And then after that, it goes to individual shots. And after eight shots, they start eliminating. They eliminate eighth place, and then it's an elimination every two shots from there.
Okay, and like I said before, after qualifications, the qualification scores do not come over into the final round, actually. Everyone's starting off with zero, so it's really anybody's game, you know?
Yeah, it really is.
And we've been seeing things changing on the scoreboard constantly, even right down to the last shot. You think you know who's going to win, and then all of a sudden things change around really fast, which is great for the spectators to see. I'm sure it must be unnerving for the shooters, you know?
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay, so like you said, now they're doing the sighting and preparation time. Can you go into detail about this, of what they're doing?
Really just getting set, fine-tuning everything, and just making sure their position's set, making sure that they'll have a good way to build up and start and start off.
And it's a kind of a time to calm down as well, do you think?
Yes,
yeah,
definitely.
Okay.
Get focused.
Now, for viewers out there who have never watched shooting before, can you just explain a little bit about the clothes that you wear?
Yeah, we wear the jacket and the pants more for stability. They're made out of canvas and leather, and they just give you more stability in areas so you can hold that gun up for longer.
And you also have some kind of funky shoes.
Oh yeah, they're flat on the bottom and they're rounded and they just help you get everything consistent.
What do you think this sport would be like if you didn't have those?
It would be more of a challenge, but eventually everyone would get used to it. With all the new rule changes, it's kind of like changing our outfits a little bit too. They had to trim off the edges of the boots, and so it kind of made some differences with like bending them a little bit.
Okay. It's okay. So we're going to get this started in almost about 40 seconds. What do you think? What do you think the end result will be? I mean, we have no idea even how it's going to start off, but if you had a choice, who would you think is going to end up on the highest step of the podium?
You know, I think Chang. I think she really will do well. I watched her shoot today, and I think she has a good shot at it.
And you said that you were shooting right next to her, is that right?
I was, yeah. Yep.
Also, during this sighting and preparation time, do you think that you go through like a mental type of workout?
Oh, definitely, yeah.
Yeah.
I know after every match you get a little mentally tired. And coming back for a finals, it definitely takes some out of you too.
And it's really important that all these women start out really, really strong, because if they don't, then it's quite hard to make up points.
Yes.
Wouldn't you say?
Definitely, yep.
Okay. So we're on to the first series. Here we've got Chang on our screen right now. Like we said before, Kelsey, you said that we've got 150 seconds for each series, and we'll see how the first series go. And it doesn't seem like anyone's really quick to shoot today. It seems like everyone's taking their time, and you know, 150 seconds does not seem like a whole lot. To fire three shots. How do you feel about it?
I know I've had to practice it because it's not a normal routine, but it's doable.
Okay. UNGERANK starting off with a 10.5. And here is our Olympic Games gold medalist, starting off with a 9.9. That's kind of surprising coming from Yi Siling. She's always so great. You know, if she ever wins the gold medal, she's such a ham. She's really, really great to watch. That's more like a 10.4. Yves starting off strong, a 10.6 and a 10.4. Arsovich starting off with a total of 30.8. We just had Chang shoot a perfect 10.9. Mazurova to finish up with a 10.6. So let's take a look now at the standings after the first series. We have Chang holding on to first place by 1/10 of a point. UNGERANK is in second place. And just behind her, 1/10 of a point, we have EVESQUE. Arsovich is 3/10 of a point. I mean, it's such a tight, tight final at this moment that it's anybody's game, you know?
Definitely.
Less than 1 point between first and last place. But I have to say it's very strange to see Yi Siling and tied up now for 7th place at the bottom of our scoreboard. That's not normally like her, you know?
Yeah.
Okay, once again, we've got series 2, 150 seconds to shoot at 3 shots. Have to see how this goes for Jessica Mager. She's shooting on her own home turf, and sometimes the Germans really like that. They like to be shooting on their own. I don't know if how I would feel about that, if I'd be more nervous about it or feel just at home. Nope, 10.7, I think she feels like she's at home.
I think so too.
That was kind of a surprise here from Chang. 9.7. That's going to change her standings. So let's see if she can get back into it. And this is the thing, Kelsey, was starting off with 0. You really can't afford to shoot in the nines. You know, you just it brings you right down the scoreboard so fast.
Yes, it really does.
EVESQUE shooting very well, 10.5, a 10.7. Imamgali finishing off with a 10.5. And we now have a tie for first place between EVESQUE and UNGERANK. Yi has now moved up the scoreboard. She was in tied up for 7th place. And with this great shooting, she has moved up to 3rd place. Mager is in 4th place. She's only 3/10 of a point behind. And on her heels is Chang, 1/10 of a point behind. So from here, we go on to single shots. The women have 50 seconds for each shot. And it's so incredibly tight right now. Mazurova is in 8th place right now. We've got to keep an eye on her. But really, 3/10 of a point, anything could happen. Okay, let's focus in on Yi, who is 4/10 of a point behind UNGERANK and EVESQUE. Oops. goes. I guess some good shooting here. Let's take a look now. UNGERANK has now overtaken EVESQUE. It is in first place. Yi Sling has also overtaken EVESQUE, and she is in second place by half a point. 2/10 of a point behind, we've got EVESQUE. Magar is only 1/10 of a point behind. And the woman that we're going to take a look at now with an unfortunate 8.8 is Mazarova. And a 2.1, what do you think? Is there any chance that she could stay into it?
There's a chance,
yeah? Okay. Mazarova, she's only 18 years old. You know, she's a young girl. And really the first time that she's entered into a final round of a World Cup. So we really have to, you know, take our hats off to her that she got into the final.
Definitely.
So an excellent final shot, but leaving the competition.
So unfortunately, we're going to have to say goodbye to Mazarov.
Nikola Mazarova.
Mazarova is going to be finishing off in eighth place. Let's take a look now at the standings. We have UNGERANK that is holding on to first place by 8/10 of a point now. EVESQUE has moved up into second place. CHANG has also moved up. She's in third place, only 2/10 of a point behind EVESQUE. And also, we've got CHANG and Arcevic tied up now for fourth place. They're only 1/10 of a point behind. So we're going to take a look now at Magar. She's only 1/10 of a point behind Imam Goli, so anything could happen. Stop. 10.3 for Imam Goli. For Magar. That is going to help things out for her, so without a doubt.
An excellent 10.8 for Jessica Magar.
And in fact, that unfortunate 9.7 for CHANG has now moved her down into seventh place. She is 3/10 of a point behind, tied up for fifth, Arcevic and Imongoli. So what do you think, Kelsey?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Who's call.
It's a lot of pressure to be putting on. You know, it's really anybody's game at this point. UNGERANK's only holding on to first place by 4/10 of a point. EVESQUE is down second, and she is holding on to that by 2/10 of a point. Yi is right on her heels.
Stop.
Let's focus in on CHANG. You know, we were kind of thinking that she was going to be on the podium today. It still could happen, there's no doubt about it. She's proven to be a very, very strong shooter. She's up and coming, and it could be anybody's game at this point. Oh. 10.7 for CHANG.
So lots of change.
So a lot of changes that are going on now. Unfortunately, we're going to have to say goodbye to Andreja Arcevic from Serbia. She missed out by 3/10 of a point. But in the meantime, what we have going on here, we have EVESQUE now moving up into first place. She's holding on to first by 3/10 of a point. UNGERANK has now moved down into second place. She's only 3/10 of a way from first and a half a point behind UNGERANK. We've got Yi. Still, it's so incredibly tight. We're just going to have to take a look now at Magar and Imongoli. This is when the pressure really gets on, you know, because we're going to be shooting off for the medals in just a little bit. And so when scores are this tight, I can't imagine how these women must be feeling. They know exactly where they're standing. They hear it from the presenter. And so the pressure is definitely on.
Hopefully they've had enough practice and experience to calm down in the right moment.
That's right.
Stop.
10.8 for Magger.
Oh, fantastic shooting, the highest score.
Unbelievable
of the round.
There.
Jessica Magger with a 10.8.
We are going to have to keep an eye now on Emomgli. She is now holding on to sixth place, and she is the one who's risking being eliminated. But you know, 0.3 behind Chang and Magger, who are tied up for fourth place. I wouldn't put my money down on anybody at this point. EVESQUE is still holding on to first place. She now has widened the gap. She's 0.8 now in the lead.
Stop.
Magger finished off with 10.5.
So lots of
things have changed around a lot. Emomgli is going to be eliminated from today's final. She did a great job for getting in here, the first time that she's ever entered into a final round of a World Cup. Really fantastic shooting for Emomgli. Things have changed around quite a bit here. We do have EVESQUE still holding on to first place, but now just by a half a point. Chang has moved up into second place, and she's holding on to that by 0.1 over Magger. UNGERANK has moved down, and she is tied up for fourth now with Yi Siling.
Still very, very close in this final.
For the next competition shot, hello.
So half a point is the determining factor right now between UNGERANK and Yi and Magger. And like you said before, anything can happen and there's always hope. Mm-hmm. So we'll have to see how Yi can do. UNGERANK starting off with a 10.5.
Stop.
And as you can hear, the crowd taking in a collective deep breath here. That was because they had a couple of nines. Magger with a 9.8 and a 9.6 for EVESQUE have changed things around. Chang has now moved back up the scoreboard. She's in first place by 0.3. It's just one shot to find out who's going to be eliminated, and that is only by 0.1 between Magger and Yi. Yi also, I mean, I wouldn't know how to call it if I could.
I don't know either. There are only 0.2 difference there, too.
Exactly.
For the next competition shot, load.
This is going to be the deciding factor for fifth place. And nobody's shooting fast by any means. Yi, 10.0.
Magger. Stop. There is a tie for the lowest ranking finalist to be eliminated.
We are going to have a shoot-off.
I haven't seen this yet.
We're going to have a shoot-off between Magger and Yi for fifth place. Adds a little bit of drama here, don't you say?
Stop.
.1 for Yi. Let's just see what Magger has got inside of her. 10.2, unbelievable. By 0.1, Magger has overtaken Yi.
Fifth place decided, leaving the competition taking fifth position.
competition representing the So unfortunately, we're going to have to say goodbye to Yi Siling from the People's Republic of China. Did a fantastic job. It just wasn't her day today. And we've got Magger, who's still in.
For the next competition shot, look.
And this is a big one. This is big because whoever is eliminated will not have a chance for a medal. The other three will, and Magger is only 1/10 of a point behind Evesque. And you can tell these German spectators are very excited about the fact that Magger just shot as well as she did. Excellent scores here. We have Chang still holding on to first place by 8/10 of a point. UNGERANK's in second, holding on to that by a half a point, and only 1/10 of a point behind her is EVESQUE. And this next shot is going to decide who is going to be eliminated and who is going to be going for the medals. You know, there's no stress there, huh? With 1/10 of a point.
Got to try and relax and shoot the best shot you can.
I guess so.
Start.
So the real fight right now is between Magger and EVESQUE. And that's going to do it. A 10.5 for EVESQUE is putting her into the medals. And unfortunately, 9.9 for Jessica Magger is going to end her up in fourth place. She did a great job. It just was too bad of a shot without, you know, some of the spectators holding their heads in their hands right now and really upset about this last shot. It would have been great to see a German winning on their own home turf. So now what do we have? Chang. Is in first place by only 4/10 of a point.
For the next competition
and, you know, 1 point basically separating first from third. EVESQUE has now moved down into third place. She was holding on to first for quite a while during this final. And so she's really going to have to put the power on right now. We've got two more shots to find out who is going to be going home with the bronze. What would you bet on?
I don't know what I would bet on.
I'm sure you're not a betting girl.
Well, it wasn't that.
Jeez, I was not expecting that at all. Unbelievable. We have got UNGERANK now has overtaken Chang, and she is she's ahead by 7/10 of a point. Chang is still is in second place now, and she's holding on to that by 5/10 of a point. That 9.8 for EVESQUE just moved her down a little bit, but we're going to have to see what's going to happen. Anything can happen.
Stop.
Okay, this is it, the shot for the bronze. If that's coming off of a 9.8, let's see if mentally she can get back into this. Unbelievable. Everyone was really sighing and going on and on. Let's just take a look here. We have got Emilie EVESQUE from France, who is going home with a bronze medal today. She fought it out good and strong. Just not hard enough to get back onto the two higher steps of the podium, but she will be on the podium. So going into the final two shots, we have UNGERANK and Chang, and only 6/10 of a point separating Chang from UNGERANK.
Stop.
UNGERANK, only 20 years old, holding on to first place. It's a 9.9 for Chang. You can see that she was a little bit shocked by that. UNGERANK, a 10.5, and that is putting a nice 1.2 tenths of a point between UNGERANK and Chang. All right, in reality, 1.2.
That is a little ways to go.
That is a ways to go, yep. Yeah. I mean, there had to be something really drastic that could happen. And we've seen that everything does happen here, yeah. So let's just wait for the last shot to see who is going to be on the highest step of the podium. I would have to say that it looks very, very promising for UNGERANK. Done it, Lisa UNGERANK. Look at her rolling her eyes up in the back of her head. I'm sure she's so happy to have this final behind her right now. Lisa UNGERANK winning the very first World Cup gold medal. Incredible shooting today. And she's, you know, well deserved without a doubt. Gold medalist Lisa UNGERANK. Let's see if we can take a look at our silver medalist. There she is, silver medalist from the People's Republic of China, Chang Jing. She's winning her second silver medal of the 2013 ISSF season. Doing a great job. And God, Kelsey, I want to say thank you very much for joining me today.
Thanks for having me.
And if anyone can hear us with all the singing going on around us, good luck with your studies and good luck with your training.
Thank you very much.
Gentlemen, would you please welcome your medalists? Ladies and gentlemen, the medals will be presented by Mr. Gerhard Forner, Vice President of the German Shooting Federation, Mr. Frank Schreiber, Secretary General of the International Shooting Sport Federation, and Mr. Tomislav Sepich, member of the ISSF Administrative Council and president of the ISSF Rifle Committee. Your bronze medalist, representing France, Emilie EVESQUE. Your silver medalist, representing the People's Republic of China, CHANG Jing. And your gold medalist, representing Austria, Lisa UNGERANK. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Austria.